Hey guys, what's up? I'm IModernArts here, and today I'm showing you how to make a sound effector in Cinema 4D. So first of all, let's show what the effect is for you guys who aren't familiar. So you can see I have those colored bars that are synced with a music file. So first of all, you're going to go into iTunes and choose which song you want to do. And I would go into your genre and choose something that's either like dubstep, electronic, electro, something like that, because it's going to work the best. And make sure the part or the song has a good, really good first 10 seconds. Because you can only use the beginning part of the song and not really the middle, or it's really hard to sync. So I'm going to use this black and yellow remix, so I'll show you guys it. Alright, that's the first 10 seconds, and it sounds pretty good. If you guys want to know what that is, it's black and yellow DJ Q remix. And you can get on this song is sick. But anyway, once you've chose your song, you're just going to go to advanced and do create wall version. And once you've done that, you're just going to rename it to wall version so you're not confused. Alright, so I got my song. I can get rid of iTunes for now. And you're going to go into Cinema 4D. Alright, first thing you're gonna do, you're just gonna add a floor where everything's gonna like sit on. And then you're gonna add a cube. And make these values for the size, make them all 50. And then you're gonna take that, and then you're gonna go to MoGraph and Cloner Object. And you're going to drag that cube so it's a child of the cloner object. And now go to your cloner object and go to object and change the mode to radial. And then put the plane to XZ. Let's put the radius to 350. And the count to like 25, something like that. Alright, after that, make sure your cloner object is selected, and go to MoGraph and do sound effector. Alright, this is what's going to be pretty much creating the effect. You're going to go to sound file, and you're going to click on these three dots, and now you get to choose the song that you want to use for the effect. And now if you play the animation, you can see the bars already start following the beat. And you're going to change your apply mode to step. And after that, go to parameter and check off scale. And just boost up the Y value to something like 10 or 8. Depends on your song. That's just going to be pretty much choosing how tall these bars are, pretty much. And now you can go to fall off and choose the shape to box. And just play around with the size values so it pretty much matches the shape of the sound effector. So you get something that looks like that. And now if you want to start adding some colors, you can go to parameter and color mode and make that user defined. And click on the color and choose a color that will match with another color. So I'm going to do black and yellow, obviously, because that's a song. So this one's going to be yellow. And then you can go into your cloner object and go to transform and make this color the color you want it to match with. So I'm doing black. I guess that color combo doesn't look that nice, to be honest. But obviously you guys can use whatever color colors you want. And finally, I think you can also go to cube and do fillet. You just change the fillet radius to like 2 or 3. And yeah, guys, that's pretty much it for the effects. Really simple, really easy to do. But you guys might have been wondering how to do it. So that's how. And thanks for watching, guys, and please subscribe.